Shark Tank, it's That City Show with your host, Eric Crossland. Plus things are happening with Jenica Lambert. Music by Polly Pocket. Today's guest is Henry Florsheim. I'm your announcer, Benjamin Rimmert. And now, will 2019 be the year he sells his house? Eric Crossland.
Oh, I got all the holes filled in and all the things that would make
a buyer go,
what is that big old hole over there? And then I have to say, oh, I got my water main fixed and I did it myself, so good luck with that.
There's definitely not corpses on this property.
Hey, welcome to That City Show. What city?
Wichita Falls.
Hey, it's...
Don't go to Eric's after dark.
Yeah. You become mulch. So, hey... Christmas was great, right, guys?
Wow, what'd you guys get?
Oh, so, man, that shirt I got.
Great.
And that new house I got.
Yeah, remember when we helped you move in? Wait, has that happened yet? That hasn't happened yet.
It'll be the day this airs.
I don't know. Oh, remember when we helped you move today?
My bad. We're in the future, y'all. Just believe it.
So our three-second post today is going to be 2019 predictions. As we learned on the last show, 2019 is going to be my year. Eric Crossland, Public Information Officer, and 2019 is going to be A-OK with me.
Right. It might even be the best year ever.
It might be.
I'm your social media marketing specialist, Benjamin Rimmert, and 2018 was pretty good, but I got a feeling we're going to keep crushing it in 2019.
What's the pose, that?
Yeah.
This power pose. It's a little limp, but I'm liking it. All right, I'm Jenica Lambert.
Love that one.
At Riverbend Nature Center, and I think 2019 is going to be all right. Okay.
All right.
I got to keep your expectations low.
I normally do. This year I'm ready. Mm-hmm. Just not to have to drive 2 hours to work every day would be a win for me.
We'll see about that.
To and from. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that's
you.
Happening this year. Okay. If I have to light that house on fire, I'm getting out of here. Evidence.
We've got proof.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Nicole Welch, a.k.a. Polly Pocket, band leader here at That City Show. And I predict in 2019 that ball will remain life. You know, ball is life. And that the World Cup is won by the Cubs.
All right. The World Cup.
Is
right? That's the right sport, right?
No. But let's keep
going. I know nothing, and I know that's wrong.
Oh, that's perfect, though.
Ball is life.
You don't know sport ball?
You never know.
The Dallas Cowboys will win the British Open. No big deal. No big deal.
At this point, they probably
Looking
have a better...
Hey!
I'm sorry.
Hey! Our guest Henry Florsheim would probably agree with you. Mr. Norlean Sates.
I have no opinions.
Did you do a pose? Did we get a pose from you?
She did.
Oh, that's right.
That was my dinner today.
Similar to the carrot.
That was great. All right. Have I been wearing those the whole show?
Huh.
That'd be weird. All right, so it is time for everybody yet nobody's favorite part of the show, City Biz. City Biz, City Biz for you and me and everyone. City Biz, City Biz.
Oh my.
Yeah, I don't think it's the thing.
It can't handle the party.
Let's add that to the 2019 list. New monitors.
Yeah.
KRK6s will be just fine.
It's going to be the best year.
I think that Yamaha's from the 80s. Continue.
Back before there was stereo,
yes.
Mono.
Hey, City Biz today, you just got done with the Christmas trash schedule.
You sure
did. Now it's time for the New Year's trash schedule.
God dang it.
Get ready to keep being upset about it.
That's right.
But here, I'm going to try a new graphic transformation
boy,
from you.
2019. Wow.
Fidget spinners
anyway.
Are still cool to Ben.
So the trash schedule.
Bring it in 2019 with fidget spinners.
It's going to transition to
2017. Yeah.
It's going to do things. But hey. Trash, your pickup stays exactly the same unless your trash gets picked up on Tuesday. It is now going to get picked up on Wednesday. That's it. That's the change. Monday is normal. Thursday, Friday is normal. Just not Tuesday.
No organic pickups. No reuse.
Hold on.
Plus, there's a graphic that'll illustrate better than the way that I'm explaining it.
Better than the mouth words that are
the
coming
mouth
at
words.
You.
Anyway.
This is your public information officers.
In other city news. New year, new you. I wrote that. It sounds way better on.
Everybody has written that.
All right, so
plagiarized that.
The health department wants to help you quit smoking.
I wrote
smoking
that.
Cessation classes start on Tuesday, January 15th. To sign up, you'll need to call 940-761-7918, or visit WichitaFallsTX.gov, which you should do anyway because we just updated the site for 2019. It looks awesome.
Now, we're talking cigarettes, crack cocaine,
tobacco,
smoking.
Tobacco, and that includes dipping and smoking.
Mainlining.
You need to either call or go to the website, though, to register for the God, I'm doing terrible today. Anyway, sign up for it. Get help.
Stop smoking.
You still got that loan on your mind? You got your house loan on your mind?
I don't
know. Being an adult is hard sometimes.
I'm doing way better
it
today.
It is. Ben was stressed out yesterday. He didn't feel good about his performance on the show.
For about 10 and a half minutes today.
All right.
I feel like very specific.
That was Rip and Tear. We forgot it last week.
City Biz,
or did we? And everyone, City Biz, we'll try to make it somewhat fun. Guys, we're going to take a short commercial break. When we come back, one of our favorites, Henry Florsheim, is here. When we come back, you're nice.
WichitaFallsTX.gov presents 100 Ways to Save Water. Number 81,
compost!
Adding a layer of compost to your lawn makes it truly water efficient. All of this organic stuff improves soil health by allowing more water to enter the soil and be stored underground, which leads to plants developing bigger and deeper roots. This translates into over $3,000 per acre per year in water savings just from using organic compost. Reduce your water costs now by composting.
Breaking in for an important news announcement from the Wichita Falls, Wichita County Public Health District.
It's time to save the fingers. Learn more about diabetes. It starts with prevention, education, self-management, free classes for individuals at risk for or have type 2 diabetes. Know your numbers and learn how to live a healthier, more active life. Go to doihaveprediabetes.org and take the risk assessment and call 761-7975 to register for classes today.
Fact, adding E to something does not make it harmless. E-cigarettes are not approved by the FDA. No one knows exactly how safe they are. Most e-cigs do contain heavy doses of nicotine, and many manufacturers market these addictive products to youth. For more information about e-cigarettes or quitting smoking, visit WichitaFallsTX.gov.
Back to that city show. Is this the first one of the new year? No, the new year happens in a couple of days.
It's like the 28th today.
This is the very end of 2018 for you. Holy moly.
Almost there.
And that was Polly Pocket on the 12s and 11s and 12s, the 24s and 26s. And there are band leader.
32.
That there is Jenica. Well, she knows what I'm talking about. Jenica Lambert, the events curator at the Riverbend Nature Center.
I got
exhibits.
It.
Did you say exhibits curator?
No, I think so.
You did not.
It was events.
You said events.
That's what I said yesterday.
Just stop trying.
No.
She does stuff. Moving on. Never stop stopping,
Jenica.
It's Benjamin Raymer. Here's our social media marketing events coordinator. What? That's, and now joining us, Henry Florsheim, president of the Chamber of Commerce.
Slash CEO.
All right. Even though I just said it, how about we get your name, your title, and your three-second pose, which is 2019 predictions to that camera right there.
Sure. I'm Henry Florsheim. I'm the president and CEO of the Wichita Falls Chamber of Commerce.
What does it mean?
I think it's a show
and
of respect.
Who dat? That's my prediction.
Saints probably have a good chance.
Saints are going to win the World Series. World Series this year.
World Cup. Right over my head.
Hey, so Henry,
Cubs have a good shot.
What that chamber do?
What'd that chamber do?
Yeah.
Our job is to build a better community. That's it. That's our job. Our mission is to build a better community through economic development and business support.
Yeah.
And so we spend our time recruiting businesses to move to Wichita Falls, helping our existing ones grow. We put on a lot of educational workshops to help business people learn how to do things that'll create
series.
A stronger business. Exactly.
The boss difficult
panel
people.
Discussions. Yeah. Yeah. It would help with this show for sure. And so we spend all day, every day, trying to figure out how we can build a better Wichita Falls.
That's awesome. What was the boss panel that you spoke on? Which one was it?
Generational
gaps. Yes.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Huh, but that was interesting.
It was interesting.
How to work with Prairie Dog.
Thank God for improv. That's all I have to say.
That's basically what that panel discussion is. It's a whole bunch bunch of improv. And that one was really fun
that
because we had, I guess you were the youngest mm-hmm. on the panel.
I don't know. There was someone that was close to me.
I think Mark from USA 800 was probably in his 30s.
Yeah.
And who else did we have on that panel?
Oh, God, blocked it out. I don't know. It was just like 6 months ago. I don't even know.
It was great, though. That was a really good one.
If you ever want to do a boss panel about how it's hard to work for dumb bosses, you might want Ben to come on.
I don't know if you'd want him to speak.
The one we did a couple weeks ago was on how to deal with difficult people.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah.
So what do y'all do to recruit businesses to come here? Like, do you like take them out on limo rides and go to bars?
It's really like any other kind of sales. You got to figure out who your targets are first. And so our key strategic target is aerospace related manufacturing. We've gone through a planning process and we figured out because you can't just go after everybody.
How would
you do that?
Yeah.
And so our number one target is aerospace related manufacturing. We've got the workforce that knows how to do that. We're an aviation community. And so we go to trade shows that are focused on aerospace. We advertise in magazines and on websites for aerospace industry.
If we got a big old factory like Toyota that just moved to the Metroflex,
we'd
get all this new blood and sales tax and property tax money and this.
Yeah, exactly.
Like in aerospace
and so we built a website aimed at communicating our story as a community. Why would somebody want to do business in Wichita Falls? And it presents all sorts of info on workforce and taxation and facilities that are available and anything else that you'd want to know about a city. And then we spent a lot of time just communicating with site consultants and corporate execs that we've talked to in the past and just to continue to cultivate relationships with those folks. So when a project comes up, we're on their list.
You're like, remember that Henry Florsheim? He was all right. Let's go move there.
And some projects will take years to cultivate.
Hey, well, and that ties into a lot of people wonder, the people who never travel downtown, nerds, why we push downtown so much.
Shut-ins, yeah, probably
and,
more accurate.
You know, you and I were talking before the show, you don't want to move. It's not appealing to move to a city where the downtown's dead and it was something 100 years ago and it's not now and the buildings are crumbling. And so that's why we are making downtown. 2018 was awesome for downtown.
It really was.
There was no half-pint
like,
a year ago. There was no brewery.
Right.
There
seems like every week something else is being announced.
Really
I was at Hook and Ladder and I saw John Dickinson in the building next door.
He and Danny purchased that one. Yeah.
And they're doing the build out and within 3 weeks or so, somebody ought to be painting it, and it's going to be built out for somebody to come in and rent it,
which
is awesome because the problem investors have with buildings downtown is they're scared of the remodel.
Right.
Yeah. And most people don't know how to do that.
One guy's got that one that has no roof on it right now.
Exactly.
So
John Dickinson is getting that building ready to rent just like, and it'll be in good shape just like it was anywhere in town.
Yeah.
And so we'll get a new...
He did the carrot. He did a wonderful job.
Oh, yeah. Well, and then one of the things we give away, either 4A or 4B money, I get confused sometimes,
4B.
Is about... getting the fire suppression system.
4B.
4B.
Yeah. 4B.
And people,
yeah.
So we give money for that pretty readily because once that system's in there, if that tenant moves out, someone can move in.
The building's ready.
The building's up to code on it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so back to your original point about why downtown's important. It's just one piece of a much bigger puzzle.
Sure.
Think about all the things you would be interested in if you were going to move to a new city. Whether you're a young professional, single, or family with kids or whatever, it's going to be... What are the schools like?
Yeah. Yeah.
What are the housing options like for me? What sort of house am I going to be able to afford? What are the recreational options? What fun stuff is there to do? What shopping and restaurants and all that sort of thing?
That's one of the great things that's appealing about us. What kind of house am I going to be able to afford? A bigger one than
exactly.
A lot of cities.
Yeah, exactly. And so
our cost of living is really low.
It really is. And so when you go to visit other cities, more often than not, we're going to downtown. If we're going to a conference, unless it's at some resort hotel, a lot of times it's in a downtown district or some kind of walkable area, whether it's a historic district or a new plan development, it's the same concept.
Yeah.
And so people like gathering spaces. You know,
sure.
It's that quality of place that we create where you know you can go and walk around and do stuff and see people you know. And the way downtown has progressed over the last couple of years, now you've got from Half Pint or even from Wichita Theater all the way over to Sixth Street, where Sixth Street Winery is going to open soon.
Yeah.
Yep.
The district keeps expanding
out
a little bit.
Yeah.
And now at nighttime, you've got a dozen options
of
places to go have a bite and a drink.
Yeah, I heard a weird complaint all the time that there's no parking down there. There is so much parking down there.
Yeah.
We need to do something.
Yeah. You will walk farther in the Walmart parking lot.
You really do.
Some days
for sure.
Than you will downtown.
The
thing is, when you go to a big city, you'll park and walk 6 or 8 or 12 blocks and not complain at all. But people here still think, I can't park right in front of where I'm going.
Well, I'm just not going to go. Getting out in the sun and walking a little bit is good for you.
Yeah, that's crazy. Physical exercise. Don't be afraid.
So, and one of the things, because we're actually kind of getting into the segment already, Henry, but I could talk to you forever about this stuff. Let's hit the schools real quick.
What we do know is that they're planning to call a bond election for November. We were thinking it was going to be May, but it's November, which is great
because
it gives them more time to assemble proposals, get feedback from us, and then adjust. And then they have to actually call the election by August.
So people vote in November. So it shows really more of what the people really want.
Well, and they knew, especially after what happened last May with the city's bond election, they knew they needed more time to educate the public before the election.
By the way, when this building collapses and we're all crushed in the studio, thanks for not.
Yeah, thanks.
That'll be our last season.
We got to spend $30 million to renovate this building. Thanks.
22.
And so they've got almost 10 months right now to still spend educating the public on why these things are important and to put their proposals together.
I could do this. Well, you already have 12 kids.
Yeah. That's why I'm 17.
It's 17.
Yes.
Is that true?
I don't know.
Henry lost count.
Six. I have six.
Okay.
Yeah. I have a question for you.
I just learned
too.
A whole lot about you.
The 90s were crazy.
I don't know how many. It's been a few years.
Well, hey, wait a second. We adopted 3 kids, so for what it's worth.
You're a New Orleans saint. I think anybody who adopts kids is awesome.
And has them regularly.
What you got? I got a question for Henry.
Are
you sure you have a question?
I'm trying to think of how to word it. There's people that will say, you know, we don't need to focus and spend taxpayer money on, downtown, that you should focus that money on giving tax relief to attract businesses. And I hear you say a lot of times that we don't have labor for them. You know, someone's like, oh, well, we need to get Amazon here. It's like, cool, do we have 50,000 people that are qualified to do that job over at Amazon? Or even, you know, welders or something that makes more sense
for
our
starters, you know what you get when you do that? When you only focus on trying to recruit companies to move to town and you ignore your schools and you ignore downtown, what you get is Wichita Falls. That's how we look, because we didn't invest in those things for the longest time, thinking that getting more industry is going to fix all that, and it doesn't. You have to dedicate those resources to it. We're going to continue to recruit companies to try to get them to move here, but we've got hundreds of industrial jobs that are available today.
Yeah.
Our plants, our manufacturing community could hire 100 welders tomorrow if you could somehow find them.
We always have like 30 open positions at the city.
Yeah.
It's always.
Yeah, and so it's not just manufacturing. Yeah. There are labor shortages across the board. Our unemployment rate is 3.1%, and that means people that are wanting to work and are qualified, they're working in some job or another. So we've got to figure out how to do that. So a big part of our new economic development strategy that we're rolling out this next year is focused on identifying and creating better pathways for citizens of all types into the workplace. And so that could be a stronger internship program to give students real experience over an extended period of time before they graduate. That could be working closely with the base to identify trailing spouses that are highly educated, helping them find employment. Because a lot of companies don't want to hire a trailing spouse because they might only be here a couple of months.
Henry, do you want to tell people how they can get a hold of you at the chamber if they want to get involved?
Yeah, I can do that.
Fill it out.
Nice. Easy.
Okay, we had the TVs go to Halloween when Ben was talking a second ago. Everybody saw that. We'll just leave
it. It's my electricity.
Polly, you ready?
What?
All right, we are going to take a break. Henry, don't go anywhere. We'd like to stick around for the third segment.
I'll be here.
When we come back, we're going to hear a performance of Things Are Happening, which is, we learned last week, is in all of our heads all of the time now. And we will hear about what things are happening when we come back with more That City Show.
Why the long face, hashtag?
Hey, press release. My grandma needs her medicine, but I don't know if I missed a bus or not. This is really bad.
Don't worry, old friend. You just need to download the Double Map app from Google Play Store or iTunes. It allows you to track routes in real time. Never be late for your bus again.
Perfect. I'll download it right now.
Smart thinking.
And now I know.
And knowing is half the battle. Ooh, you did miss your bus, though.
No!
Welcome back to That City Show, last episode of 2019. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
18?
2018.
Whatever. That's Polly Pocket.
It's
right
Halloween.
There. She's up there bringing us the music.
That's it.
We have got so many compliments on Polly Pocket this year.
Really?
We were getting food at Qdoba a couple weeks ago, and the guy in line is like, hey,
she's
those
great.
Guys from that Falls Town live show? And he was like, yeah, that's a good ad, Polly Pocket. She's a class act. And I was like, oh. So if you know someone who works at Qdoba, I don't know.
It's so I love Qdoba.
I named the show That City Show because I thought everyone would be going, That City Show? And everybody, I missed it. It's That Wichita Falls Show is what
it is. Yeah, it really
says.
Is.
That's what it should have been named.
It's okay.
Anyway, that's Jenna Kalammer. She's the exhibits
that
curator so at the Riverbend.
I thought it was events.
Most people watching at home probably think that,
it's
too.
Okay.
That's Benjamin Rimmer, social media marketing specialist, Eric Cross, the public information officer, Henry Florsheim, the president and CEO and founder of the chamber. No, you didn't.
It's 1908.
Yeah, that's
new.
Right. You look great. All right, it is time for Things Are Happening. Polly Pocket, we are sad that they won't be Christmas themed anymore,
okay.
But I'm sure you've got something just as cool as always. Take it away when you are ready.
We're going to spin it back the original.
Oh, okay. Black bars, anybody? I don't know who to choose from.
All around the clock, just around the block, things are happening. There's always something to do in every hub issue. Wichita Falls has events. Wichita Falls has activities. Blue skies and golden opportunities. Experience theater, museums, concert festivals, and fairs. Shopping parks, sports, nightlife, and a 20-mile trail. The City Show will put you in the know, and the here Jenica's got the down low. So get off the couch, out of your pajamas, choose Wichita Falls, and go
bananas! Oh, there we go. It's like all of us are trying our hardest to distract.
That was amazing.
Thank you so much.
It's not easy to perform in this room.
There are so many things to do here.
It's
very intimidating.
It is a great song. We love it. All right, Jenica, what that
I love it.
Thing do at the city. I never know
Activities.
How to happen. Things are happening. What things are happening?
All right, things are happening. Wichita Falls Brewing is presenting a six-hour downtown. Sorry, now I'm all messed up. Stop it, Eric.
It bothers me that everyone leaves the word company
off. What's going on here? I'll read what's in front of me.
God dang it.
Everyone knows. There's only one.
MPEC events.
The Wichita Falls Brewing Company is hosting a six-hour downshift mountain bike race on Saturday, January 19th. Got it out. Yeah.
Hey.
All right. This ride's going to be taking place on the Wichita Trail. Each lap is about 6 miles long. So basically, you're going to, most person who does the most laps will win. You don't have to continually.
Yeah. In a 6 hour period.
Continuously do it for the 6 hour period.
Yeah.
If you want to, if you're just that.
It's more
awesome.
Like show up.
I can't
up.
Even sleep for 6 hours.
Is anybody in this room going to do that?
No.
I'm going to show up and drink
watch.
The beer.
I don't physical activity. But anyway, so that's going to be really fun.
I don't physical.
But anyway, whoever wins is going to get cash.
Yeah,
so hey,
there's cash pal.
Right? Wichita Falls Brewing Company will be there to quench your thirst when you're done. So you can search them on Facebook. They have a Facebook page. You should like them. They do stuff all the time.
Yeah.
And yeah, check it out. WWE Live.
They're coming back.
Yeah. There it is. To Wichita Falls, Sunday, January 20th, the K. Yeager Coliseum. Watch
and
Seth Rollins versus Dean Ambrose, Braun Strowman versus Baron Corbin.
That's right.
Braun
Strowman's going to kill him.
Sasha Banks, Bobby Lashley, and many more of your
Sasha
favorite WWE
here?
Superstars live.
The boss.
I remember them having different, like, these all sound like normal names. that?
They don't do it as gimmicky as the
guys
do. Yeah. And the women used to be like swimsuit models and couldn't wrestle, and now they're better than the men. Like they headline, and they like really are good.
Yeah, my favorite wrestler was the Junkyard Dog. That's the best name ever. Right?
I like Junkyard Dog.
I came out with a big chain.
I was a Macho Man Randy Savage guy. Huh. Rest in peace.
Oh, that's depressing. All right. Anyway, they're coming back to the King Coliseum.
Not Macho Man.
So again, it's January 20th. You can get your tickets at the WFImpact.com website. They're $15, and I have a feeling that's going to be very entertaining.
If you're coming from out of town to come watch that, because I forget we're in Oklahoma. Go Wrestling Hall of Fame and go check out that. It's really cool.
That
this guy
is
doesn't
such
like
a place.
Wrestling, and he loves it in there.
Yeah.
We it is like the only brick-and-mortar
like
wrestling hall of fame in the world.
It is true. The WWE one isn't real. It's not. They're not in the building.
No, that's
take
that,
like, Vince McMahon.
That's right.
They're in the Bear and Big Blue. They're kind of hard to miss.
Yeah,
so
it's really cool. And there's an area for kids to play with toys if they're not that interested.
Stretch Armstrong.
My kids love that place.
Yeah, it's great.
All 17 of them.
Don't go and introduce family over there. There's no room for you.
You guys must eat a lot of macaroni and cheese.
I would. I do
it's the best.
What's wrong with that? It's delicious.
You feed it to kids.
Yeah.
You probably got to get the family size.
Plus Beanie Weenies.
Which I get anyway. But
two family sizes.
I love Beanie Weenies.
All
right.
Anyway,
backdoor.
You like
Beanie's
Weenies.
Beanie Weenies.
Oh.
They're delicious and processed. all right, so things happening at Backdoor. My Way opens on February 8th. You got a time to get your tickets for that. There's auditions for Cry It Out. That's happening January 13th.
Eric does that regularly every day.
I can imagine.
And the star, Eric Crossley.
So for more things to do, you can check out the Hub
at
choosewichitafalls.com.
Which is also our closed captioning sponsor. Thank
Yay!
You.
Thank you. And hopefully
Sam
they can do
bill
so
month.
In 2019.
That's right.
Have a wonderful new year.
Oh, thanks, Jenica. Hey, Henry, one more time, if people want to get involved with the chamber, you don't have to throw it out this time. Give them a phone number or a Facebook page.
Wichita Falls Chamber. I look confused.
You do. You're like,
what?
He's thinking about all his kids.
I have no idea what's going on right now.
What do you mean I don't want to be married?
I thought I was happy.
You don't have 17 kids. I was happy.
Listen to him. Apparently I'm not.
It's a lie.
Check us out on Facebook or WichitaFallsChamber.com, or you can call the chamber at 940-723-2741.
Okay. All right. Thanks a lot, Henry. Polly, take us away. Hey, we don't know who next week's guest is. We haven't scheduled out past 2018, but I say that now. We're going to get inundated, which is good.
Call
us. And
I'm just kidding,
we will see you next week. Thank you so much.
Next year.
We'll see you next year. That's right. On behalf of Henry Florsheim, Polly Pocket, Nicole Welch, Jenica Lambert, Duckface, Benjamin Rimmert, the saluter, I'm Eric Crossland, and this has been
That City Show.
Delicious. We'll be right back.